How far away is the beach from where you live? If you're American, you'd probably answer in miles. But if you're from almost every other country in the world, you'd probably answer in kilometers. So while Susie from America might say that she lives 2 miles from the beach, Kiara from Australia might say that she lives 3.2 kilometers away from the beach. 2 miles and 3.2 kilometers are both the same distance, but they're just represented in different units. Since people use different units, it's critical that we are able to convert between units so we can accurately convey measurements to one another. In science, there is a standardized system of units known as SI units. While kilometers are the standard unit for distance, miles are a customary unit because within American culture, people are accustomed to using them. So how do we convert from one unit to another? First, we need to know what the conversion factor is. We can look this up online or in a textbook. Let's do an example. If I travel 241 kilometers to get to the beach, how far is that in miles? The conversion factor tells us that 1 kilometer equals 0.6214 miles. We can write this conversion factor as 0.6214 miles divided by 1 kilometer. Then we multiply the distance in kilometers by the conversion factor. So 241 kilometers times 0.6214 miles over 1 kilometer equals 150 miles. The kilometers in the numerator cancel out with the kilometers in the denominator, leaving us with the distance in miles. We can write the general formula for converting units as initial units times desired units over initial units, which will equal the desired units. Okay, now let's try a challenging problem. We're driving to the beach at 60 miles per hour. What is that in kilometers per second? So first, let's get our conversion factors. We know that 1 kilometer equals 0.6214 miles and that 1 hour equals 60 minutes. And that 1 minute equals 60 seconds. I like to work out my dimensional analysis problems on train tracks like this, because it's easy to follow which units cancel out. You want all the unwanted units to cancel out until you're only left with the units that you desire. So 60 miles per hour becomes kilometers per mile, then kilometers per minute, and finally kilometers per second. You multiply across the top and then divide by all the numbers in the bottom row to obtain your final answer with the desired units. In this case, our final answer is 0.027 kilometers per second. Converting units can be tricky, but is extremely important and, like everything else, becomes easier with practice. And maybe, after solving all of your dimensional analysis problems, you can work out how many centimeters or kilometers or inches it will take you to travel to the beach.